हेलो गाइस, माय नेम इज शैलेशु फ्रॉम मुंबई महाराष्ट्र। वी वेलकम यू ऑल टू आवर ऑनलाइन लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म दैट इज डीजे मरीन। वी गिव यू सम नोट्स एज वेल एज गाइडेंस टू क्लियर क्लास 4 सीओसी। सो टुडेस आवर न्यू टॉपिक इज स्टंट ट्यूब एंड दीज आर द टॉपिक्स विच आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस सेशन इन स्टंट ट्यूब। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द मोस्ट डिसाइडेड क्वेश्चन फॉर एमईओ क्लास 4, दैट इज व्हाट इज स्टंट ट्यूब, ड्रॉ इट्स सीलिंग अरेंजमेंट एंड व्हाई टू हेडर टैंक्स आर यूज इन स्टंट ट्यूब। सो व्हाट इज स्टंट ट्यूब? लाइक वी कैन सी हियर, अ स्टंट ट्यूब इज अ हॉलो ट्यूब दैट रन्स थ्रू द बॉटम ऑफ द शिप फ्रॉम द मेन इंजिन टू द प्रोपेलर, एज यू कैन सी इन दिस डायग्राम। लाइक कंसिडर दिस इज द प्रोपेलर, सो स्टंट ट्यूब इज जस्ट बिफोर द प्रोपेलर विच गाइड्स इट, होल्ड इट एंड टेक ऑल द लोड्स एज वेल एज इट रेस्ट्रिक्ट द आउटसाइड सी वॉटर टू कम इनसाइड द शिप। एज यू कैन सी नाउ इन द डायग्राम, दिस इज द हॉलो ट्यूब एंड नेक्स्ट दिस इज द सेक्शन, क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द स्टंट ट्यूब। लाइक इन बिटवीन देर इज अ बियरिंग एंड फ्रॉम द साइड्स देर आर टू सील्स, इनवर्ड सील्स एंड आउटवर्ड सील्स विच रेस्ट्रिक्ट द फ्लो। What is purpose of stunt tube? First one is to withstand the load. As we know, the propeller which hangs at the aft and exerts load on the shaft which is supported and withstand by the stunt tube bearing. The bearing is a cast iron bush lined with a white metal having excellent load handling and lubricating property. The stunt tube is fitted at the stern frame and internal framing of vessel's hull at aft peak. This allows the tail shaft to rotate smoothly in the bearing area for uninterrupted propulsion. Next one is the sealing. The stern tube bearing consists of sealing arrangement to prevent ingress of water and to avoid the lubricating oil to escape into the sea. So coming to our next topic, that is types of seal. The first type of seal is stuffing type of seal. This type of seal are used in the sailboats, small motor ship boats which will have a stern tube that is slightly bigger than the propeller shaft. The packing inside the gland nut and creates the seal. The shaft is wrapped by packing and put in the gland nut. Through tightening the nut it into the stern tube, the packing is compressed, creating a seal against the shaft. Stuffing box material are of stainless steel, brass or any other material specific to other application. Our second type of seal is lip seal. It is called a lip seal because the shape of like a lip. It is connected to the tail shaft to prevent lubricating oil or water passing through the shaft. It consists of number of nitrile rubber rings of special cross section. In this lip seal materials of nitrile rubber, there are 3 lip seal in aft direction and 2 lip seal in forward direction. The lip seal are tightly pressed against the chrome liner with the help of garter spring. As propeller rotates the chrome liner, as you can see in this diagram, the water pressure is also helping the garter spring because the chrome liner is rotating. So they both are pressing against the chrome liner so that the sealing can be done effectively. Coming to our next topic, that is stern tube lubrication system. The first one is seawater lubricated stern tube system. This is the most traditional type of lubrication system which are used in shipbuilding. As shown in this diagram, the tube is constructed of cast iron with a flange at its forward end and a thread at the aft end. The tube is inserted from the forward end and the flanges is bolted to the aft peak bulkhead with a gasket to ensure the water tightness. Inside the tube, there is a brass bush which has grooves in it running forward and aft direction. Strips of lignum vitae, that is a hardwood, are fitted into grooves to act as a bearing for the shaft. Small spaces are left between the lignum vitae strips. Through this space, water can enter, lubricate as well as cool the shaft. A watertight gland is fitted at the forward end of tube to prevent water from getting into machinery or tunnel space. But slight leakage is allowed to ensure cooling of the packing. A brass or gunmetal liner is chunk fitted to the tail end shaft. Bearing length is mostly of 4 times the shaft diameter. If bearing is over 380 mm diameter, the forced water lubrication must be used. A circulating pump or other source of water flow is being used in this system. As we just now saw, the working of water lubrication system. But still nowadays very few ships are using such type of system. So why it is so? We will see in its advantage and disadvantage of this type of system. The first one is advantage, natural lubrication assisted by seawater. Second one is predictable wear rate allows scheduling of dry dock in advance. Third one is no sophisticated forward or aft seal is required in this system. Fourth point is no chances of pollution due to leakage of oil into water as in case of oil lubricated type. Nearly all outboard bearing until 1960 used water lubrication system but not used much nowadays. Let us see the disadvantage of the system. The first one is excessive wear down of bearing material was caused by the trend to large ship sizes which has higher bearing load. Also larger ships generally operate at deeper draft and with less clearances between the hull and the channel bottoms. More contaminants such as silt, mud and sand are drawn into the bearing clearances causing their wear down. The second one is poor quality of work when rewooding or during the dry docking. Inferior material was being used. So presence of sand and sediments in the water required early rewooding. Vessel with engine aft and particularly tankers and ore carriers which spend long period in ballast. Sometimes rewooding in 18 months have to be done. And the third point is shaft needs extra liner for seawater protection. So by using oil lubrication stern tube bearing, above problems can be eliminated. Oil lubricated stern tube bearing also reduces the power loss in the shafting system. Also, oil is better vibration damper and superior. Coming to our new topic, that is simplex type or oil lubricated stern tube bearing. The shaft is protected from metal to metal contact with bearing by oil lubrication which is supplied from a header tank in engine room. Starting with this diagram, first there is a drain tank you can see. It is located at the aft side bottom deck which is filled with the stern tube lube oil and it gives suction to the stern tube lube oil pump. There are two stern tube lube oil pump because if one fails then the other will be useful in that case. Then the oil passes through the oil cooler where cooling medium is water or oil. Then the oil fills up first the upper header tank, then it overflows, then it goes to the lower header tank and after again it goes to drain tank, such circulation goes on continuously. So when you want to use a lubrication system, there is a three-way valve present there, whichever tank you want to use it, that valve you have to open it and then use as a lubrication system for stern tube. As you can see, this is the area where the lubrication system is being used in this as shown in the diagram. There is a differential pressure gauge between them which senses if any different change in the flow, like if some water comes from outside then there will be a change in the flow because of the immersibility of oil with the water. So it checks and gives the signal as per the change in flow or the change in pressure. Now coming to our MMD oral question, that is why two header tanks are being used in this system. As you can see that for ballast condition we use lower header tank and for full load condition we use upper header tank, right? As the load changes, like some ships like ore carrier, bulk carrier or oil tanker, big large VLCC ships, they are having a huge change in the draft due to different change in condition like in loading as well as ballast. So the draft changes as per that condition, so we require certain pressure head as per that condition. Like if you are in a ballast condition, suppose you require a certain height of 2 to 3 meter above seawater pressure. Like an example, consider there is a center line of a propeller shaft and the outer water level pressure is here. So the pressure, assume the pressure, water pressure acting at this point is 1 bar. So the height of the gravity line should be such that the pressure head acting at, pressure head should be 1.2 bar to 1.3 bar at this point. So the basic idea is that the stern tube oil pressure should be greater than the outside water pressure by 0.2 to 0.3 bar as shown in the figure. Coming to our new diagram, that is it is an overall view of oil lubrication system. In this system on the left hand side you can see a rope or a net guard which restricts or does not allow any foreign rope or net particle inside the system. Then in a pink color you can see a lip seal which is guided by a garter spring which pushes against the chrome liner. And the chrome liner you can see which is mounted with the propeller boss by using a bolt system which also rotates with the propeller and the garter spring pushes against the rotation at this point. We can see that both the sides are having the seal, forward seal and aft seal. Forward seal having the two seals and two lip seals. And in aft there are three lip seals. At the point of aft seal, as you can see, the chrome liner is mounted with the clamp or a flange, which is also rotating with the propeller. The purpose of using a chrome liner in both the side is that if you directly use the lip seal pushing towards the shaft will have the grooving in it. So to prevent it from grooving, we are using a replaceable chrome liner due to which the grooving can be prevented, and each dry dock we can replace the chrome liner easily. As shown in this diagram, there is a cooling water tank which is surrounding the whole stern tube by using a fresh water. The fresh water is supplied by a normally bilge line, like the bilge pump or bilge and GS pump. Fire and GS pump are used to supply the cooling water. It should always be filled up to the stern tube because it is used to constantly cooling the stern tube. Now coming to the forward seal tank, how we will know that number 4 or number 5 is leaking? Let us suppose number 4 is leaking, and the same condition, the gravity tank oil will be coming through the forward seal tank and there will be overflow in the forward seal tank. And consider now the number 5 is leaking. In that case, the forward seal tank will be a tank will become low. The oil will become low and all the oil will be go to the engine room, and then we can ensure that number 5 seal is leaking. Now the next question is that what to do when number 1, number 2, number 3 all seals are leaking, and what are the actions to be taken? On this condition, we have to first inform our company as well as whichever port we are going next. We have to inform them beforehand that all the three stern tube seals are leaking. So in that case, because when you are in the ongoing ship, that time there will be some emulsification, there will be some time, but as soon as you stop the ship, all the oil will be come outside and there will be spillage of oil. So pollution is concerned, so you should contact with the port previously, so that as soon as you stop your ship, they will make a scaffold around the ship so that the oil shouldn't spread much. While moving towards the port, while the journey, you can, if you are in your ship, you are having too abundant oil like Hydrox B or Seal Guard, you can use it, or some any other very high viscous oil to be used in the gravity tank, so that till that time there will be less leakage and till you reach the port. And as soon as you reach the port, you have to shut the gravity tank line, and whatever the oil should be contained at much possible. And then in the afloat position, you can change the seal, of course by using experts. There is one more question related to it. What to do if there is a leakage from number one, number two, number three seals due to grooving of chrome liner, and you are in the mid sea and you are very far from the dry dock or any port. So in emergency case, what to do? In that case, we can see in this diagram there is a shim or a spacer ring is being present, right? You have to remove that spacer ring so that the placement of the where it will be pushing the seal will be changed from that position, and then again there will be sealing will be present, and you can again use for some period of time. Some ships don't have two header tanks, only one header tank is enough for them, like where there is not much considerable change in draft. Like in container ships, such ships don't have the much difference in draft as compared to the VLCC oil tanker or bulk carrier. So some ships you may have that only one header tank is being used to control the as per the draft. There is one more system in oil lubricant system, that is called as air guard system or pneumatic system. Some of your ships you are having, there may be a pneumatic system in that in your ship. So that part we will cover in the next video, because the video will become too long. We will come with a new video in a new day.